On today's Tech Talk, we're going to discuss engine displacement and the difference between a small block and big block engine. So a while back we did a poll talking about what kind of engine you guys wanted us to see in Project Bedding. We talked about doing a small block, a big block, mod motor, a Coyote. We talked about the Godzilla motor, possibly even an EcoBoost. A couple different options came up. And a lot of people actually asked, what is the difference between a small block and a big block as far as a build like that would go? And I started thinking about it, and it's like, you know what? What's the difference? Well, the big block's bigger, obviously. This is a big block Ford, this would be a small block Ford. You can see, you know, the block is bigger, the crank is massively bigger, you know, the heads will be larger, the valves will be bigger. But what makes it a big block? What separates the big block from the small block? Is it cubic inches? Well, it isn't. That's where displacement comes into play. You can have a 396 cubic inch big block, and you can have a 400 cubic inch small block, and there's several other setups as well. You know, Fords, if you get into the Stroker Windsors, you get a 408, even bigger motors that are all still considered small blocks, or like I said, you have a 390, a 396, a bunch of smaller big blocks. So what's the difference? Well, let's take a look at both these blocks and go to some details. So what's the difference? Like we said, the big block is physically bigger. We could say, you know, bigger block, bigger heads, bigger valves, bigger crank, end of video. But let's talk about displacement. Now, the two engines we have in front of us here, we're gonna call this a 429, which it actually is. And this one's gonna be our 302. Now, if you actually know what you're looking at, you might notice this is a dart block. This is obviously a little bit bigger, but it's what our machine shop handy. So again, for video purposes, this will be our big block 429, and this will be our small block 302. So let's talk about displacement. Displacement is a measurement, and it can be cubic inches, cubic centimeters, liters, whatever you want to use. We're going to focus today on cubic inches. Now, what is displacement? It is a measure of the swept volume across all the pistons moving inside the cylinders. Now, your pistons connect to your rods and connect to your crank, and they're going to move at different speeds, but that volume never changes. So how do you figure out displacement? Well, displacement, there's going to be a formula for it, and there's a couple different ones you can use. We're going to use 0.7854. You're gonna times that by the bore. Now the bore is gonna be the width of the cylinder here. So basically, however wide this is, that's gonna be your bore. So what you can do is do 0.7854 times the bore squared, and then we're gonna times it by the stroke. The stroke is how far the piston moves in and out of the cylinder. So again, that comes down to the crankshaft. That's where the term stroker comes from. We'll get to that later. But basically, the movement of the piston is gonna be the stroke. So on our 5-liter engine here, we know this bore is going to be 4 inches. And we know the stroke is going to be 3 inches. So do the 0.7854 times the bore squared, which is 4 squared, will be 16, times 3, then you times it by the cylinders, and that'll get us to the 302, which is the displacement of this engine. All right, so let's talk about a stroker motor. The most common one in the Ford family is going to be the 347. Everyone's heard of that. They call it a stroker. Well, why is it a stroker? Well, you're going to change some things in the block to create the stroker. Like I said, with a regular 302, your bore is going to be 4 inches, and the stroke inside here is going to be 3 inches. Now, how do you get a stroker motor? Well, you increase the stroke, and in this case, you increase the bore as well. Now, with a small block, basically, you're limited on how much you can open these up. Your factory bore spacing on the 302 is 4.38 inches. So basically, the center of this hole to the center of this hole is going to be 4.38. So when you're actually going to bore these out for a bored stroker motor, you can see you only have so much material to go with. So the 347 is going to take this and take it from a 4-inch bore to a 4.03. So when someone says 30 over, that's actually what they're talking about. 30 thousandth larger, again, will require a custom piston. But then you're also going to change the stroke from 3 inches to 3.4. So you're changing the crank, it's basically going to change the stroke, and that's how you get the additional cubic inches. Now here we have our big block Ford. Now again, like I said before, obviously physically larger. Now big blocks were originally designed for larger sedans and for trucks because they wanted a bigger engine, more cubic inches, more physical engine size to move the heavy vehicles. Obviously hot rodders got hold of big blocks, started sticking them in small lightweight cars, the manufacturers followed, and basically that's where the muscle cars came from. You know, most of the most desirable muscle cars had big block engines because in a lightweight car they made them nice and fast. Now here, this is a 429 big block Ford. And again, you can see the bore spacing, huge, huge difference. There's a lot more material in here, but it's also larger to begin with. Now this is gonna be a 4.36 inch bore, so much larger than our small block, and a 3.59 stroke, so again, much larger. You know, combine that with the 8-cylinder engine and do the math, and it comes out to 428.79, somewhere in the neighborhood, which basically is a 429. But also you can see by the bore spacing, there's a lot more room in this big block. Now up close, you can see a huge difference in the bore spacing. Like I said, our small block, you're talking about 4.38 inches. The big block is 4.9, so there's a lot more meat there, a lot more material that could be ground away to put a much larger piston in. You could actually go much, much larger with the bores, go with a stroke or crank, and make a lot more cubic inches than you can do with a typical small block. So when it comes down to your conventional factory-built blocks, you know, the limit on a small block is gonna be in the low 400 cubic inches, where big blocks, you can go well over 500 cubes. Now, aftermarket blocks, there's a lot of different options there, but again, talk with more of the conventional factory-produced blocks, most motors over 400 are gonna be your big block, where a lot of your small blocks will be under 400. So for our build, we decided to go with a small block. What we're building is gonna be a 331. So like the 347 we discussed, the 331 is gonna have a 30 overbore. So that bore is gonna go 4 inches to 4.030. The stroke will be 3.25 inches instead of 3.4. So a little bit less stroke than the 347, but still a stroker motor. Now 331 versus 347, we won't get into that. There's tons of articles out there. You can read up on it. We talked to our engine builder about the car, what we're gonna do, and that's what he suggested, and we're gonna go with that setup. Now, which one's right for your car depends what you're gonna do. Now, the benefits of your big block engine are obviously gonna be larger cubic inches. You're talking larger valves, a ton of torque. And the benefit of the small block and the reason we went with it, a lot of it has to do with weight. Now, your 302-based engine, it's gonna be a lot smaller and a lot lighter than the big block. And for a car that we're trying to build for handling purposes and to be a really good street car, the small block fit what we were looking to do. Now, again, the big block, unlimited cubic inches, tons of torque, but it's a heavy rotating assembly, so you're not gonna get a ton of RPM out of it unless you go to really, really exotic components, where again, your small block, you get a lot more RPM out of it at a lot more reasonable cost. You're gonna give up some torque, but again, then we're getting into power adders, which can be a whole different video, but again, they say there's no replacement for displacement. A lot of the turbo and supercharger companies might actually argue that, but either way, whether you're looking to build a small block or a big block, both can be the right solution for your Mustang.